Hello, my name is Hsien, and I'm here to talk to you a little bit about Frankie's visits to Singapore. Frankie was here about 10 times from 1998 till 2008, and he taught and he shared not just steps and stories, but a way of approaching the dance with feeling, so that even though we were weird Chinese people trying to learn this weird American dance, he could bridge the gap and make sure that we felt we could do the dance. He never alienated us and never said, you can't do it because you're not from my culture. But he was always very welcoming and always very glad and happy to see us dancing. So there are actually so many Singaporeans and Asians who have learned from Frankie. And if you talk to any one of them, you will know that the great impact that he made upon them wasn't his amazing dancing, but he was an amazing dancer, but it was how he could just live his life in this positive, generous manner, and that he could share with us that dance was really for everyone. He was open, he was so happy to see us dancing, and he inspired us to really want to keep sharing this culture of Lindy Hop, not so much just the dance, but really the culture of welcoming and of inviting everyone in. So Sinclair very kindly asked me to share some of our memories of Frankie, and I wanted to share some of the pictures and videos that we have of him in Singapore. So the first one here was actually not in Singapore, but it was the first Singaporeans that learned Lindy Hop with me. And it was a small group, but before I felt brave enough to invite Frankie to Singapore, we actually went to London to learn with Frankie at an event called the Swing Masters Jam. Chun Pon, Selwyn, Yu Qian, Lai Ping. These are my university friends, and they are the first guinea pigs that I taught Lindy Hop to. Not long after that, I did invite Frankie to Singapore, and this is the first event in Singapore where Frankie and Aaron came to teach us. This was at the Dance Circle Studios in Alexander Point. In 98, Frankie also went to Tokyo. This was his second Asia stop, and Hiro from the Tokyo Swing Dance Society arranged some workshops with him and I. In 99, Frankie came again to Singapore, and this time with Aaron again, to open the Jitterbug Swingaphore Studio in Tras Street. So he cut the ribbon with Aaron, and he watched the Shim Sham. Jin Kwek is in there. And he took photos like a proud grandfather. In 99, we also had an event at the Kashba, which is at the top of the Mandarin Hotel. And the Greg Chaco Band played swing music, jazz, and we danced, and of course we did the Shim Sham. Greg Chaco was one of the first musicians that invited and welcomed the swing dancers to come and dance to live music. We were very lucky that he was playing at the Raffles Hotel, and we would turn up there and dance, and we were just very lucky to have live jazz music. And we brought Frankie there too, so that was really nice to bring Frankie to hear live music in Singapore at the Raffles Hotel. He thought that was pretty swish. From 2002 till 2008, Frankie would come to Singapore for C-Jam. C-Jam was an event, was one of the first Lindy Hop camps in Singapore, and of course Frankie was always the main star, and we were very we wanted to have it by the beach. That's why it's Sea Jam, play on the location of Southeast Asia, and of course by the sea. And Frankie really loved the hot warm weather. That was one of his favorite things about coming to Singapore. 2008 was the last Sea Jam that Frankie attended, but in person, but of course he was always there in spirit and mind thereafter. And he still is a very strong part of all that we do here all the Lindy Hoppers that have met with Frankie or danced with him, whether in Singapore or in Harang or in any other dance camp, cannot forget his strong presence. Frankie passed away just before his 95th birthday, and here is a tribute that we did Singapore on the City Hall steps to wish him a happy birthday, and went into the magazine of the Frankie 95. There was a big event that to honor him, and there was a magazine, and this is the photo that went in. And every year, just like this year, it's a time where Lindy Hoppers can really focus and remember not just Frankie, but all the elders who have come before and all the legacy that they have left behind. Because it's not just one person that created the dance or developed it. It does take a community. And as part of that continuing community, we want to make sure that we remember and carry on this tradition of being together and not being separated. For Frankie's 100th birthday, I was very honored to be part of the committee together with Mandy Gold, Elliot Donnelly, Tim Collins, to organize Frankie 100, a big event in New York City, bringing together not just Frankie, but all the elders that were the surviving elders of Lindy Hop, and to honor all of them. A bunch of Singaporeans made the trip as well to New York City, and it was just so wonderful to have the homies hanging out there and celebrating Lindy Hop with the rest of the world. And as we reach Frankie's 107th birthday today, or World Lindy Hop Day, I'm just so happy that to find more and more, not just Singaporeans, but Asians in China, in Malaysia, in Hong Kong, Vietnam, Taiwan, Thailand, so many new people joining the Lindy Hop family. I just hope that we can continue to remind and remember not just Frankie, but all the other elders who have paved the way for us and created this dance and this music and given us this big present. And despite their own problems and issues and of discrimination, of racism, but yet they remain joyful and positive. So I hope that we can continue to remember their stories and continue to share them and to honor them in our dance. Thank you for celebrating Frankie with us, and I hope to see you next year and the year after and the year after.